From this tutorial, we will start new series on SolidWorks. At first, we will learn some basic command. Click on New. Then select Part. OK. Then click on Sketch. Then Sketch. Select the plane. Then at first, we will see Line command. So click on Line. Give the first point. Take the cursor away. If line is straight, it will show a yellow symbol with horizontal line. If line is inclined, it will not show any symbol. And when line is vertical, again it will show a vertical line with yellow box. So give the direction and click. To come out, right click and click on select. To pan the drawing, press Ctrl and press scroll button and drag the mouse. If you want to give dimension to the line, click on Smart Dimension. Select the line, then give the location and put the length. Press Enter. Then press Escape. So in this way you can create horizontal line. Suppose if I want to create inclined line, again take the line command. Click the first point, then click, then you can also escape to come out. Then for inclined line, you will have to give the angle between two lines. So for that, again click on Smart Dimension, click on the first line and second line and click inside and give the required dimension. Then suppose if I want to create an equilateral triangle, then again line, click this point and this point. Then here the angle will be 60 degree for equilateral triangle. So give the angle. So in this way you can create equilateral triangle. So in this case, if you view properly, there are two colors are there. One is black and one is blue. So black color lines means those are properly fully defined actually, and the blue color lines are need to define more parameters. So for this line, if we give the angle, that means it will be fully defined. If we select the first line, second line and the inside and give the angle, then its colors also become black. And here you can view that indicates fully defined. That means this sketch can be used for 3D object. Press Escape. Then to create circle, here is the circle command. Click on circle. Then give the center point. Drag outside. Then again Smart Dimension. Click on the circle. And give the diameter how much you want. If you click on the arrow, after the circle, there is one more circle command is there, perimeter circle. That means you can create circle tangent to three objects. So suppose I click this line and this line and press escape. So it has created circle tangent to three objects. By dragging and by pressing delete button on the keyboard, you can remove the object. Then if you click arrow after the line, there is one more command is there, center line. To create center line, just drag the point, click the first point, then to just pan it, then second point, right click and select. Again center line, suppose drag the point. Escape. Now if you want to give distance between these two lines, then again click on Smart Dimension, select first line and second line and click and give the length. Press Escape. Then suppose I want to create one circle here, then one more circle here, If you want to catch the intersection point, you have to pay attention to the symbol near the pencil symbol. When it is like this, that means you are catching the intersection. Now you are catching a point on the line. And now there is change in the yellow symbol. That means it is catching exactly the intersection. Give the intersection and give the dimensions. Now it is fully defined. Okay, then suppose I want to create one line tangent between these two circles. So click on line, then click on first circle, then take your cursor to the second circle. So drag the mouse until a tangent symbol displays there. So when you drag the mouse, the tangent, now a circle and inclined line is shown. That means this line is tangent to this circle. So when the tangent symbol is displayed, after that you have to click there. So it will create line tangent to both the circle. Press escape, again line, click on the circle, then go ahead, tangent symbol is displayed, then click, then escape. If you want to remove the unwanted object, for that you can use trim entities. Click on trim entities, then the fastest is trim to closest. That means wherever you click, that entity will be trimmed. So that is a trim to closest. If you want to zoom, rotate your scroll button towards user. That means it will zoom plus. If you rotate the scroll button towards monitor, that means it will zoom minus. And from here you can give the zoom fit. Then here is zoom area. Click the first point, drag the mouse and release the button. So it will give zoom area, zoom fit. Then if you want to pan, then press control, press scroll and drag the mouse. So it will give the pan, zoom plus, zoom minus, pan, zoom fit, zoom window. So all those different zooming controls you can use. Press escape. Then that is the trim to closest. So wherever you clicks, it will be trim. Then there is one more thing, command is power trim. So in this power trim, you just have to press the first button and drag the mouse. So whatever the objects are crossed, those are trimmed or deleted. So power trim you can use for delete also. Suppose I will just undo it. From here you can undo. Okay. Then if you click on trim again, trim. Then the next option is corner. If you want to create some corner, I will create one line here. Escape, right click, line. So there are these lines are there. If you want to connect these two lines or connect these two lines, then you can use this corner option. Click on corner, select the first line, select the second line. Select the first line. So the area of the line you want to click, keep that on that side you have to click. So it will keep the area where you clicks and it will remove the opposite area. So in this way you can use corner option. Then next is trim away inside. We will create some more object. Escape, right click. So again trim away inside. So it will, at first you have to select two object, then you have to select the object which you want to trim. So it will trim inside object, and if you want to trim all the object, press first button and drag the mouse and release the mouse. So it will trim all the objects. So using Ctrl Z you can undo. Again trim, then trim away outside, so it will trim away the outside object. Select two object and click on the object, so it will trim on both side. And if you want to trim all the objects, then press first button, drag the mouse and release it, so it will trim all the objects. So that's all. So we cover here the basic things. If you want to view the exercise solved on this lecture, you can visit this area. If you want to view the next lecture, visit here, visit this video. You can view the complete playlist here, and you can subscribe from here. Thanks for watching. We will stop here.